Greetings! In this tutorial, we'll see what's new in FL Studio 20. Let's start with the version number. We jump straight from FL Studio 12 to 20 because we're celebrating 20 years of FL Studio and lifetime free updates. We'd like to thank everyone who ever purchased FL Studio. Without your support, FL Studio wouldn't exist. Okay, what's new? FL Studio now supports Mac. FL Studio is a native 64-bit macOS application. Projects are compatible between the Mac and Windows versions. If you have the same third-party plugins installed, there's nothing more to do other than share the project or zip file. And for third-party plugin support, you can use both Mac VST and Audio Unit plugins. The best news? FL Studio licenses unlock both Mac and Windows versions. That means Mac users covered by lifetime free updates can start using FL Studio natively on their Macs today. No more to pay. Time signatures. FL Studio now supports multiple time signatures, and you can set time signatures for patterns and the playlist independently. I'll right-click this pattern to set it to 3/4 time. The time signatures are represented as time markers. Click and drag them as needed. Notice the piano roll grid follows. If I add a pattern to the playlist, I can use the clip menu, use current time signature from pattern to playlist. This will add the 3/4 time signature to the playlist where the pattern starts. Or you can directly add time signature changes by making a selection and choosing Shift Alt T. The project's default time signature, set on the Project General Settings tab, will be added to the end of the selection. Here also, drag to reposition the time signature. Notice the metronome follows the time signature changes. By adding a time signature change to the pattern, you can span the time signature change in the playlist if needed. Excellent. Consolidation. Consolidation renders clips to audio. You might do this to save CPU, to create stems for sharing, or to create audio for further remixing and manipulation. There are now three ways to consolidate audio. The first consolidates everything on a playlist track. Let's hear. Right-click the playlist track and select Consolidate this track from track start, meaning from where the track data starts, or song start. We'll choose from the start of the song. Afterward, you could disable both the instruments and effects involved if they're not used elsewhere in the project. And here's our consolidated track. The second way is to consolidate clip selections in the playlist. Here I'll select these vocals and merge them into a single vocal wave. From the playlist menu, select Tools, Consolidate Playlist Selection from Selection or Song Start. Vocals consolidated. There's a light over the ocean. Cool. Finally, you can now render and replace patterns. In this case, just right-click the clip and select Render and Replace. Done. And you can undo it too. Nice. Arrangements. An arrangement is the layout of audio, automation, and pattern clips in the playlist. Use the drop-down Arrangements menu on the playlist title bar to manage multiple versions of the project to work out ideas or sound design, for example. I'll clone the current project to make a version without the vocal. There's a wind touching me. There's also handy tools for merging arrangements. In this case, I'll merge the original arrangement with the vocals back into Arrangement 2. The unique clips will be copied across. in this case the vocals. Note that arrangements share the channel rack and mixer layout, so be careful not to delete channels, effects, or mixer routing used by other arrangements. New playlist features. While we're in the playlist, let's have a look at some other enhancements. First, you can now hide grouped playlist tracks. Hidden tracks are indicated by the down arrow. And there's more tracks. We've increased the playlist track count from 199 to 500 to help those who would like some more room to spread out. There's also a new mini preview scroll bar. From the menu, select View, Mini Playlist Preview, Enable. You can choose a single or double height. There's a similar option for the piano roll too. This will make navigating complex projects and scores a little easier. Improved audio recording. Audio now previews as it's recorded. There's a light over the ocean. There's a wind touching me. You can also set punch-in, punch-out recording markers. These automate the main recording control. There's a light over the ocean. Finally, when loop recording, takes are now grouped. There's a light over the ocean. 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 And don't forget to use the new Consolidate Clips feature to compile your best take. Let's clear the decks and check some of the new workflow features. There's now a playlist menu option, View, Resize All Playlist Tracks. Great for restoring all tracks to one of the preset sizes. As the new Consolidate feature mutes the consolidated clips, we've added two new playlist track right-click options, Mute and Unmute All Clips. This will allow you to quickly revert to the original clips if needed. Last for the playlist, we've added some new chopping presets. Plenty to explore there. Classics updated. By popular demand, the step sequencer Graph Editor is back, and better than ever. And we've improved the note editor. You can expand the note and other editors from the lower right corner. Use your mouse wheel to scroll vertically in the piano roll. We've also made improvements to the sampler channel, including two kinds of sample start. Start offset simply moves the start point. Sample start trims the sample to the start point. This can be useful when working with pre-computed effects that process the entire sample. We've also restored the classic pre-computed effects, including boost with clipping, so you can make a distorted 808 bass straight from the sampler channel. Also, old favourites like ring modulation and pogo. Plenty of sound design fun to be had there. Plugins. We've made updates to 25 plugins, so we only have time to cover a few of the highlights. Fruity Reeverb 2. It now has a modulation section. Use the modulation amount and speed to break up the ringing or metallic sounds. Or for more creative uses. Fruity Convolver. We've added a plugin delay compensation control just above the editor window. This allows you to correct impulse latencies so PDC now just works. Related, there are two linear phase EQ presets. Linear phase EQ, long compensated and short compensated, that make use of this feature. Slicex. the Regions menu has a new Set All Cut Groups To option, which assigns the same cut group to all slices. Also, slice mixer track destination names are now shown when you right-click the Send control. DirectWave. Zone loop types can now be set for all selected zones at once. There's also a new Copy Selected Zones option for popular zone parameters. Edison can now export to 24-bit WAV files. ZGameEditor Visualizer. Layers can be collapsed to make complex projects easier to navigate. Buffered layers are more obvious, they're coloured. And among other things, new effects like U-Lean's Blur. Check the manual for details. Finally, a new VFX plugin. VFX Level Scaler scales note properties received from the piano roll. Most parameters are automatable, so it's a great way for modifying piano roll scores. Excellent. Mixer updates. The mixer now includes 125 tracks. There's still more to come with future FL Studio updates. Plugin delay compensation has been completely rewritten from the ground up and now just works in far more cases. This includes compensating sends, and that includes multi-input and output plugins. The effects wet-dry control is also now latency compensated. This means classic parallel compression needs no more effort than tweaking the knob to partial mixes. Finally, by popular demand, you can now reset selected mixer tracks. Enjoy. Toolbar update. FL Studio 20 introduces a fully customizable toolbar. You can save and load presets, and even have a single bar. In edit mode, just drag and drop elements to and from the toolbar. When you're happy, save your presets using the menu on the lower right. Thrill seekers can even choose to have one toolbar at the top and one at the bottom, or even both at the bottom. I'll stick with both at the top. By the way, don't forget to activate the news panel and keep updated with the latest news about FL Studio and plugins. User data changes. We've moved the user files to a FL Studio subfolder in the system user data. On Windows, that's Documents, Image Line, FL Studio. And on macOS, Documents, Image Line, FL Studio. This will help with future updates, as your personal files will be separate from the installation folder. And with that, we're sure you'll love FL Studio 20 just as much as we love your lifetime free updates. Enjoy.